But these were people who would be somewhere. I mean,
exactly.
Do you have an enclave somewhere?
Oh, no. No, I live an independent private life, and I do seminars. I don't have dormitories.
Okay, you don't have dormitories.
No, nothing.
So if someone wanted to rescue this child, where would they go rescue her?
What they did was they went to Seattle, and at the time she wasn't even attending my seminars or anyone else's. And this Lisa Hughes person was one of the deprogrammers and called, I guess, Jennifer's parents or in some way incited them and told horror stories about me and what I do. And her parents paid around $25,000 to kidnappers to grab her. They locked her in a motel room for 10 days, showed her Charles Manson videos.
So she couldn't go to your seminars?
I hadn't seen her in a long time. I heard this story after a while. And she told me about this whole experience. And that's when I realized that all the people making these accusations are affiliated with or part of the CAN organization. And evidently, they don't like me or my politics.
And you're considered a cult?
I guess. I just do seminars. I don't have followers. I've, you know, people who attend my seminars.
Okay, one other thing, and then we'll get into what happens at the seminar. We'll take calls. Nancy Knupfer, K-N-U-P-F-E-R, well-paid bank vice president, apparently quit her job, moved to Boston to help you open a new center. Uh-huh. She said, you and your movement are a cult. For a period of time, she was part of the cult, became under your influence, went to Boston, changed her whole life. She said, you're dangerous. Her sister is still a member of your group. Nancy has not been able to communicate with her sister since she left the group.
I understand Nancy and her sister just got together on a television show that they're doing about me in San Francisco, and her sister was in the audience, and it seemed to upset Nancy quite a bit, so I guess they've been together. Nancy didn't help me open a meditation center. She was a person who attended a few meetings, I guess, and she has said that I paid a flight attendant for TWA to drug her coffee to prevent her from getting to Los Angeles. I didn't know TWA. I thought they were the Friendly Skies or something. She asserts that multiple black Porsches were driving around following her. It gets ridiculous. She asserts that her shoes were sprayed with a special spray to attract dogs. This is in a video that she made about me for the CAN organization. It gets absurd.
I feel like I'm in another world here. Why you?
Well, I guess...
I mean, a lot of people do seminars.
Yes. I guess that my seminars have been successful for about 19 years, and they've just gotten bigger and bigger.
Do people walk out in a trance? Do they leave your seminar, call their family, and say goodbye forever, Dad?
Not to my knowledge. I don't even meet the people who attend my seminars, by and large. They come in, buy a ticket, and you do an evening for them. I just did Lincoln Center. We had 2,000 people there. You know, they're very large. There's no personal contact, per se. But I've been doing a lot of advertising lately, and I'm just a likely target if you want to become famous putting somebody down.
You don't travel with any entourage?
No, of course not. One of the things, it gets silly. There's a newspaper in Los Angeles called the LA Weekly that ran a story called Busting Rama. I didn't know that there was anything to bust. They assert that one of the things I do is get my so-called followers to eat peanut butter. They assert
that
I don't understand this. They say that I recommend...
I love peanut butter.
Well, so do I. Peanut butter is a great thing.
Take me to your peanut butter.
But, I mean, I don't understand what the problem is. I teach seminars. They're very mainstream. I do them at Lincoln Center and every place
else.
You talk
about making money. Do you deal with that?
Definitely.
I mean, it's real world Western kind
yes,
of thing, right?
Yeah, I'm very pro-career in the development of your career. I'm a former university professor, as an English professor, and I believe in education, I believe in self-development and working.
Meditation is used how, do you believe? How would meditation make someone, let's say, a better wage earner?
Well, to begin with, you have to get a definition of who you are and what your goals are, and most people are pretty fuzzy on that. Meditation is to center us, to bring us a sense of stillness and direction, essentially so that we can figure out what is we want to do and have a clear mind to go about doing it.
But your interest is they pay for the seminar, what they get out of it, you hope they get something good out of it.
Oh, I
there's
give them
no
my
cult,
best.
There's no following, you don't ask them to lead you, to go somewhere with you. Okay, we're going to pause and come back and take your phone calls for Zen Master Rama, Dr. Frederick Lenz. You are primarily a teacher of meditation,
that's
right?
That's me.
And you deal with spiritual advancement and material prosperity.
Yes.
Okay, we'll be back with your calls after this. This story gets curiouser and curiouser. I asked Rama if he was doing a seminar here in Washington. He said, no, his next seminar was in March. And I said, where? And he says, Palm Springs. And I would bet you're the only cultish leader taking people off into the hinterlands and doing it in Palm Springs. We go to Albuquerque, New Mexico. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Hi, fine.
I had the misfortune of being accepted as one of Frederick Lenz's students just before he became Zen Master Rama in 1984. And after questioning Rama on the issue of sexuality and seduction of several of my best girlfriends, he called me a witch at the next center meeting, and on the phone, personally, I spoke with him. This was at 2 o'clock in the morning, and he publicly kicked me out, claiming that I was an occultist. Rama, what is an occultist, and can you please tell us a little bit more about the allies and how you use them?
The allies, what is she talking about? Hold on, don't hang up.
I'm not quite sure. Could you explain what you mean by allies?
What do you mean? Ma'am?
Allies, in other words, Rama used to talk about allies and entities very often in his center meetings. And he used the expression to term as a term for discarnate entities, which he used to send against people. They're like demons. And he would send them against people and attack people psychically with them.
What is an ally, as you mentioned in a seminar?
I have suggested that it is a good idea not to get involved with too much trans-channeling. Okay, you're aware of trans-channeling. Mm-hmm. That's when a person gets in touch with spirits. And my theory is it's like just dialing out and dialing a random phone number. And I know it's very popular, and maybe some people have good experiences with it, but I don't think it's a good idea, personally, when a person doesn't know what they're doing. So I tend to bring people away from this whole area and suggest that they get involved with career development and structural mental development.
What do you mean by allies?
An ally is a name that was popularized in a book by Carlos Castaneda for non-physical beings and forces. And, you know, saying that I send demons against people, I think, is a little bizarre.
Well, what do you mean by your girlfriend's caller?
Well, my name is Brenda. After questioning him on the issue of seducing several of my best girlfriends...
Are you saying he seduced several of your best friends?
Yes, he would call them up in the middle of the night after finding out whether or not their husbands were still in town through investigations from Sarah Swati and Prema. And when their husbands were discovered to be out of town, he would call them up in the middle of the night for a quote-unquote meditation session. And lo and behold, when they got to his house, he would ask them to go to bed and have sex with them.
Hey, all right.
Well, first of all, I don't know who this person is.
You don't know Brenda?
I don't know Brenda or any Brenda in New Mexico, certainly. Secondly, I've never made it a habit to go out with people who are married. I've gone out with a lot of very wonderful women who are single, but this is an absurd idea.
You're not anti the sexual act?
Of course not. I'm quite pro, actually.
Okay, thank you. We go to Los Angeles. Hello.
Hi, Larry.
Hi.
Great show yesterday with your boss there.
Ted Turner, yeah.
Yeah, great man. I'd like to ask Zen Master Rama if basically what you say is that you teach people meditation, how to meditate and advance in their careers and their lives, but I'm married to one of your ex-students, okay? Is it not true that you originally started in New York, you moved to San Diego, you asked people to follow you from New York to San Diego, you asked some of those people to follow you from San Diego to Malibu, and isn't it true that you also had a lot of your students doing a tremendous amount of personal as well as some of your business work for you to drum up new business for students as well as make them make not maybe a large financial drain on their income, but a fairly sizable financial drain on their income? These people were struggling to survive while you were living like a king, driving in Porsches and buying Porsches for some people in your inner circle.
All right.